Hey guys, welcome back. So guys, in this video we are going to continue our REST API or RESTful API in CodeIgniter, which is CRUD part 3. And now guys, we will get started with this. So as the data is shown into our database in the employee table, we have only one record. Now we want to insert more records using Postman. Okay, so we will be using this Postman to insert the records into our database using REST API. Okay guys, so let's get started with it. So let's get back to our controller. Where is the employee controller? As we have continuing in our CodeIgniter REST API series. And now guys, let's create one function. So as you know, we have created a API controller, where inside this now we will create one more function, public function, which is we'll call as a store employee function. Okay, so inside this, now to get this as a post method, you have to add here as underscore post post. Okay, so this is the important thing for posting the data for your API. Okay, so now guys, you have to call this controller, right? I mean this method inside your API controller. So for that, let's click a route for it. So let's create one route. So let's just copy the same thing and let's change it. Employee forward slash, I am going to give store. And inside this, I'll go to API employee controller with what method? Which method is that? Okay, employee underscore post. So we don't have to take this employee underscore post because this will be used for the postman or a post method. Okay, these are used for the methods and the thing which is left behind that. So we will copy this and paste into your route. So we will call according to this. So this is the main your method. After that, whatever extended is there, that is called by the API controller. So that is the REST controller which is called it. So guys, now let's start with this coding over here. So now what we have to check, let us check whatever the data we post, we should get over here. So one example I'll show you. Let's create one dollar data, where inside the array format, I will just print and show you. Over here, I'll call employee name, right? So let's just show you with the first name. So let's call that first name. FIREST first underscore name, I'm going to call that, where with the help of dollar this of input method, where post of your data. Okay, so over here we will pass first underscore name. Done. So this will be we have to fetch. So let us just return. So as you returned over here, so let's return that over here. Let me just copy this and paste over here. So now let's just check with it. So let's copy the route. For testing purpose, we are doing now. After this successful testing, we will be doing for the CRUD. So let's get here and give a forward slash and paste that. Store, and this is not get, we have to put it to post. And coming back to your body, inside this body we have to select on form data and the name whatever you have given. So let's take that name, which is first name. Let's copy this and let's go to postman. This will be the key, and here we'll give funda test. So let's see what happens now, the result of it. Okay, so the first name is funda test. You are getting the output, right? So whatever you are going to fill, that will take with the post method and then in show over here. So with the help of this, we are going to store all the data into our database. So guys, cool, tested now. And now let us include the things for the model. So guys, as you created in the previous video, employee model, where you have this, the function model. And from this model, we will include in our controller. So let's call this model inside our post, where $employee is equal to employee model with the new. Okay, so now we will take this value. So before taking this value, we have to call all the fields. So what are the fields we want to insert into a DB database? Inside the table employee, these are the fields: first name, last name, phone number, and email. Let me click on the structure. It's loading. Okay, so this is the last name, phone, email. So same thing you have to paste on it. Last name, we are going to keep the phone, 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 and final one, email. Okay, the same name should be variables. So let's click on browse and let's get back to our code. Okay, so now after this, we will create one variable called result. $result is equal to where you are going to call this employee variable or object, employee object, where you are going to tell insert employee, L-O-Y-E, employee function. With this help of employee function, we will create one function inside your employee model. So inside this employee model, I'm going to pass a data. Data means whatever the input you are getting from your outer resource. So now let's copy this and get back to our employee model. It's over here, and inside this we are going to create one public function where this employee model which you have given now, and inside this you will write a query for it. So guys, that query is like so type return $this of database, where you have to use pre-built CodeIgniter builder query class. Okay, so this is query builder classes predefined by the CodeIgniter itself. So my table name is employee, so let's copy that, paste, and give a comma and paste that data, whatever you're fetching it, paste it. So once it is done, and when it will return, once it returns, it will come back to your controller where this result option is provided. So guys, what I have to do now we have to check this, whether this data is coming correctly or not. So let's comment this, and now we have to check in another format. So this was for the testing, so let's just remove that, and now we will test with it. So with the if condition, if it works, show me else you have to show the error. So what we have to check, if the record whatever saved is greater than 0, we will check. Okay, if it is greater, then $this of response response, inside this response you will check with the array method, where we will send the value one, status one we will send, which will be true, and then one message, message message, where we will send this as new employee created. Okay, I can message this, and then over here we will pass that using this rest controller. We want to send a message, so we'll call using this rest controller. We will send one default message, that is http_ok. That's it. And same thing, let's copy this and paste it over here and change the status, which will be as false, false. And now here we have to take failed failed to create employee, and instead of http_ok, we'll metal bad_request. Done. Let's save this, and now it should insert the data. So before that, make sure you are adding this _post, and in your route there should be no post. Okay, so we very clear about it. Let me check the model. Model also working fine with the correct spelling insert, and then now done. So guys, now let's test with this same names whatever you're passing it. Okay, so this first name you have to take that FireST first name where you'll be seeing in your database columns. Okay, so let's copy the same name, first name, last underscore name, next value will be phone, phone phone, and final one is email. And now inside this you are going to send that. So funda of last name is web IT and phone is some random numbers and the email is funda@email.com. Done. And now guys, let us send this using post method. So please select that post and make sure your route is correct. So let me click on this. Let's send. Okay, so sending request. Cool. So the message status is true, new employee created. So now let's check whether the data has come into your database. So let me click on browse and let's see. Cool. So the data has come over here by using post method. If you want to see the data using this postman also, you can just check with that. So let us use get, and this thing we have already created in previous video. So let's check with this API help. Okay, so you can see that ID number 2, where is funda of web IT and funda@email.com. Cool. So guys, in this video we have completed that how to insert the data using REST API or RESTful API in CodeIgniter. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Please continue in next video where we are going to get the data by its ID. Okay, so single data we will get, and further videos update and delete also will be completing. So guys, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe, like and share.